attention, ship's company. Embarkation party to promenade deck gangway. Embarkation party to promenade deck gangway.
Purser, the comms supervisor speaking. Yes, sir, you did ask me earlier to let you know the state of the cabins. They are all ready now, ready for embarkation.
Right, coming up fast.
Now, the prizes, we've got binoculars and a camera and the ramekins like we had before.
Lovely
lemons.
Spinach.
Yep, okay.
Super. Storekeeper here, sir. Just ringing to inform you that all the stores are on board. Check your door, Miss Alton.
Stand by the
door. Which takes all distance off the boy on southbound. Harbour
cable, cable.
Slow ahead, too.
Island almost in the centre of the Mediterranean Sea. Surely this is one of the finest places at which to start a Mediterranean cruise. Grand Harbour in the northeastern corner of the island of Malta. I hope that most of you have seen the commemorative plaque, the citation of the George Cross Award to the island by the late King George VI. At that time, in the Second World War, the island of Malta was almost starved into surrender, but the courage and bravery of both the fighting forces and the local residents eventually won through.
As the ship sailed out from Grand Harbour past all the fortresses, it was a lovely feeling, a curious feeling really, because we suddenly realised that we were in a completely different world.
Mrs. Marshall.
Well, good.
And Mr. Haynes.
Hello, yes. Nice day.
Yes,
one
yes.
Another.
Mr. Benson.
Evening, Mr. Benson. How do you do?
Mr. and Mrs. Hall.
Oh.
The weather around about the UK is so dodgy that you never know how long it's going to take before you get decent weather. Whereas flying out, you're right into the sunshine.
Miss Barton.
Hello, Miss Barton. How do you do?
Hello,
Mrs.
Sonigan.
Have you back?
Mrs. Rudd, Captain.
Good evening, Captain. How do you do?
Mrs. Hawkins, Captain.
Hello, Miss Hawkins. How are you this evening?
And Mr. Williams.
Good evening, Mr. Williams. Very nice to see you.
Organization. I says in the state that's the best brandy you can get because they get the biggest winery in the state.
Nice sunny day for that too. You have to start off quite early in the morning.
Yes.
You'll probably see the sunrise over the desert, which is very, very interesting. I've seen that myself. It's a glorious sight.
Well, if you've never been to the Acropolis, you've got to go there anyway,
yes,
because that's a real masterpiece of engineering, really.
Are you looking forward to your cruise?
We are with great anticipation. Yes.
Have you been to Athens before?
No, this is our first visit.
You can imagine it.
See the sunrise over the Acropolis.
Thank you.
took my breath away, I think, looking at the pyramids for the first time. The whole atmosphere of the place caught my imagination.
We were more or less grabbed and put on camels. I wanted a camel ride, but one didn't have much choice.
Hi, Lord Simba! Oh, my sweet camels. Oh, again, please. Oh, either one more.
Oh, look, Lindquist.
No.
I'll give her a pound for the lot.
Yeah,
what? No.
She
bought for 1.5 quid. I give it to her for quid.
Okay.
Hi, ho!
How you doing, Sonia?
Did any of you have a ride on a camel?
Yes.
No,
I did. Absolutely beautiful.
Oh, great.
With a hat on.
With a hat on.
Complete Adam.
How much did they charge you for that?
About 10 shillings.
Oh, that's not too bad.
Not
sometimes
too bad.
They get very naughty,
oh,
and they
yeah,
won't let you walk unless you pay another pound or something.
No, he wanted more,
right.
But I haggled a bit.
Right.
Excuse me, madam. Here, this way, madam. This way. No, he went.
This was... It was built by Muhammad Ali, the head of the royal family, in 1830, and it was completed after his death by his son. It was designed by a clever Greek architect who took his model from the great church of Sophia in Constantinople.
All the guides we had were excellent. I kept thinking of questions I would be wanting to ask them, but they always seem to anticipate your questions, and they leave you nothing to ask.
The slender minarets are most elegant and attractive, and they are seen miles away before reaching the city. Each minaret is 82 meters, the height from which the muezzin or the priest call for prayer.
As we were coming back to Alexandria along the Nile Delta Road, we stopped at one of the villages so we could all take photographs. And it was extraordinary. The villages are very poor. The buildings are like sort of hovels, I think we'd call them. I mean, we're used to all modern housing, and they have nothing like that at all there, and yet, for all that, they seem to be very happy.
Ringing, and if you feel like a drink, all you've got to do is to look up and the waiter will come along and provide you with whatever you require. Marvellous.
Service on board is excellent. The waiters are most attentive, quite the best on ships.
Have you cruised before?
Yes, we were on a ship last year up into the Scandinavian capital, you know.
Oh, it just doesn't call the capital, it's right up the field, they're really something.
I thought the food was excellent, and I couldn't fault the service in any way. In fact, I've told my wife that when we get home, she'll have to back her ideas up.
You've probably done it before, Jack, have you?
We used to wander upstairs after our meal, and there was plenty of space, many nice comfortable chairs you could just sit back and relax in. And after your coffee and drinks, you could dance if you wanted to, you could sit in a quiet corner and talk, you could just do whatever you liked.
Oh, absolutely, yes.
Then
about 10 cents.
Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day, someone waits for me. And the gold of her hair crowns the blue of her eyes like a owl tenderly. If only I could see her, oh, how happy I would be. Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day, someone waits for me.
Organization of the entertainments have been first class, I think. Not too much, you're not forced into doing things if you don't want to do them. Evening entertainments have always been very enjoyable. Having a live band, of course, aboard makes for it.
Time is 6:45. It's a beautiful morning, sir. Fine and sunny, and there's a light breeze ahead.